it's quite funny actually that I go away for a couple of weeks, and then during that period of time, there seems to be an international banking crisis unfolding at the moment, which is quite what can I say? Quite unnerving, shall we say? But I do think actually wholly predictable based upon the issues that unfolded in the credit crunch in 2008. And this is a bit of a sensitive subject, so I wanted to get on with it straight away and dive straight into it, because I know that it's causing a lot of uncertainty for many, many people. And there seems to be two camps of thought at the moment. The first is, you know, the kind of don't worry about it, it's going to be absolutely fine, nothing to worry about, these sorts of things happen, and, you know, we can all just carry on as we were over the course of the last couple of years. And then there's the other side of the camp, which is the people that are have been expecting this to happen for quite a number of years and are expecting the banks to begin to fall over at a fairly rapid rate. And it's Armageddon, and the financial system is about to enter complete and utter meltdown, and we're all doomed. And somewhere between the two of them is kind of where I reside, as one would probably expect. But if you look back to 2008, when the credit crunch first unfolded, back in the 2007, beginning of 2008, the strategy that was adopted, of course, was this approach of what was then called quantitative easing. It seemed to be that they just sent the money printers running and printed all of this cash and then pumped it into the banking system. And that seemed to prop up the financial system as we know it. What seems to be very odd about that was that some people were saying is that the banks seemingly ran out of money, but then went to the government of the world and said, we can solve the banking crisis if you borrow more money from us. And that's how we'll solve the banking crisis. And I'm like, well, how do you borrow more if you haven't got it to lend? But we won't go into all of that at this moment in time. If you start to ask some of these critical questions, a lot of this doesn't actually add up. But anyway, the money printers started rolling. We had billions and billions and billions pumped into the banking system through quantitative easing. And that has caused this inflationary bubble of asset prices increasing over the course of the last, shall we say, 10 to 14 years. But in terms of real value, I think most of us are probably reflecting upon our own personal financial situation and asking the question, how much has our own personal financial situation improved over the course of the last 10 to 15 years? And if you're in some of the professions such as nursing or you know, any kind of profession like that, then you'll probably realize that over the course of the last 10 to 15 years, you're not seeing yourself as being any better off, even though the value of your house might have risen. In real terms, the actual pay packet that people are receiving isn't actually increasing. Okay, so there comes this crunch point, and this is what I have been... I'll be honest, I've been hoping and praying that this didn't unfold, but it looks as though it is now going to unfold, that, you know, the housing market will naturally begin to slow down, or could lead to another situation that happened in 2008 where the market slowed down significantly. And that then leads to a situation where, you know, the asking prices that people are setting on properties, particularly estate agents, will have to start naturally being reduced because people's affordability just isn't there. And I think that will take a natural course over the course of the next 12 to 18 months. And it's something to be aware of. And now it's not something for us to necessarily fear unless the market obviously stops. But this is the time, and this is what I really want to emphasize. Now, if you're an estate agent or a solicitor or a surveyor or a mortgage broker, any of those professions that are watching these videos right now, this is what I really want to emphasize for you. This is the time, if you want your business to be successful, this is the time when you want to start advertising more than at any other point in the previous couple of years, okay? And the reason I say that is because traditionally, when businesses slow down and they have a fall in revenue, they then look at cutting costs. And whilst that's a survival strategy, and it's quite smart to look at doing that, so what are your superfluous costs? Where is the money leaking out of the business in certain areas? Where you can cut those costs, yes, that's very sensible. But the flip side is, you've got to generate more revenue. And this is where so many businesses sabotage themselves. And this is why I believe that so many more businesses fail during a recession, is because that a lot of people regard advertising and marketing spend as a superfluous expense that they don't need to spend. So they cut back on that, okay, either completely or significantly. And that is what I think is personally you're going to be your biggest mistake. So you've got to look at how do you generate more revenue. And you have to look at other avenues around generating revenue that is different from what your competition is doing. You need to put a distance between you and your competition. And the only way you can do that is by offering something unique. Now, I think there's many, many, many different ways that you can do this. And I'm going to point you, first of all, again, to Estate Agent Secrets. You can read this again, whether you're a conveyancer or a surveyor or, a mortgage broker, for example. I would encourage you to get your hands on a copy of Estate Agent Secrets, purely because in these three volumes, I guide you through exactly what I think, you know, people need to be doing in a market such as this. And this is what I've been, if I'm totally honest with you, preparing for planning for, that this change in the market is upon us now. And this is the time for you to really take action if you want to be successful. And if you don't want to be successful and you want to carry on doing what we were doing before and hope all this turns around and, you know, just hope and pray for the best, then that's fine. Carry on doing that. But my view would be, why wouldn't you want to implement strategies that will distinguish you from your competition and allow you to generate more revenue and drive more business into your company? Because if the market still carries on being good or actually increases, it's only going to benefit you. And if it falls off a cliff or it starts to reduce in some way, again, it's still only going to benefit you. So it's a total win-win. It's a total no-brainer in my book. But I would say that, of course, because I've written these books. And as everybody knows, being slightly facetious here, everybody knows that anybody who writes a book automatically becomes a multimillionaire. Okay, so if you think I'm saying this just to sell you a bloody book, I can promise you that's not what it's all about. But I promise you that there's a huge amount of knowledge and information and wisdom that's in there that will help you figure out this social media strategy thing, this differentiating yourself from your competition thing, in a way that allows you to stand back from the situation and really put a new perspective on the service that you're offering, so that your competition haven't got a leg to stand on when it comes to winning the business initially. Okay, so I'm going to leave it at that. If you are a little bit concerned, spend a little bit of money on a book. If you want to jump on a call with me and run through some stuff with me face-to-face again, more than happy to do that for you. I've been speaking to a couple of people this week, strategizing around property and property deals and investments and how they can structure those things going forward with the present uncertainty in the marketplace. And I'm more than happy to do that for anybody connected to the property industry, or even if you're a first-time buyer or anybody of that nature that wants to get into the marketplace and start doing deals, either pick up a copy of Home Buyer Secrets or come and talk to me directly. More than happy to jump on a call with you. And let's see where this takes you. I think, you know, sitting there hoping that all of this is going to go away and that there's not going to be a repeat of 2008, I think is, not really a strategy to embrace. Let's put it that way. So anyway, moving on, I just wanted to share that with you guys. And let's get stuck into the questions. I've missed doing these, so I want to get straight back into these questions and run through them with you. You probably noticed as well, I'm doing a slightly different approach, going a little bit more casual. I would actually like your feedback on this, whether you think a more casual approach, open neck shirt, losing the three-piece suit is actually a better approach, and you're more engaged with that as a methodology for doing these videos, or whether or not you think I should put the three-piece suit on and sweat through the summer. It's entirely up to you. Let me know your thoughts on that. Would love to hear. But I did have a bit of feedback from a couple of people in the community who suggested that this might be a better way to go forward. So you know what? I'm trying it. We'll embrace it. This is what it's all about. It's one big experiment. So let's do it. Okay. So ladies and gentlemen, that's it. Thank you for joining me here this week on this week's webinar. It's been fantastic, as always, to get back in the saddle and start answering your property questions. We're here doing this every single week. And if you've got property questions that you'd like to send in to us, you can do that via email, which is happytohelp@wiggywam.co.uk. That's happytohelp at wiggywam.co.uk. You can find us on Twitter. Twitter handle is at wiggywam_UK. That's at wiggywam_UK. Or you can go to our website, which is wiggywam.co.uk. You can sign up, join, get a free profile on there and start getting yourself immersed into the Wiggywam community. You're going to find a host of information, blogs, videos, all sorts of great resources on there that will help you with your property investment journey or your property journey if you're looking at buying as a first-time buyer or a second-time home mover. Or if you've never bought in the last 5, 10, 15, 20 years, we're here to help you with your house move there as well. So that is wiggywam.co.uk, and you can send us questions directly through the messaging system there as well, which will be fantastic. So I look forward to seeing you again next week. As I say, we are on for week 26 next week, which is going to be really exciting. And we've got some amazing things in the pipeline that are going to be part of the Wiggywam community. So stay tuned. Thank you for all your love and support. We're getting an incredible amount of interest and traction on our website right now. If you haven't submitted blogs or you haven't submitted videos to our news page on our website, I'm going to encourage you to start doing that right now, because I'm seeing huge traction, and I'm not just making this up. Go and check it out yourself. We're seeing hundreds, if not thousands, of views on these videos right now, and on blogs. People are putting blogs on there, getting 3, 4, 5, 6, 1,000 or more views and interactions on their blogs on there right now. So we're getting huge amounts of traction, and I'm really grateful for every single one of you for being part of the amazing Wiggywam community. And if there's anything that we can do to support you, please do let us know. So that's it for me this week. Thank you once again for your love, care and attention. Wishing you all the very best for the coming week, and have a wonderful weekend, and I'll see you same time, same place next week. All right. Thanks ever so much, guys. You take care. Be good. Bye-bye.